not going to call upon people to worship the rulers, because most of them are really, you know, not doing a good job for Islam. Nor I'm going to tell them, talk about the rulers. You see, those are two extremes. Talk about the rulers in a bad way. Because what benefit do we get if we keep criticizing them? And, you know, what about making dua for them? You know, Imam Ahmad, I believe, or Sufyan al-Thawri, or one of the two, he said, if there is a da'wah, if there is a supplication, that I know Allah will accept from me, I will make it to the for the ruler, not for me. ليه؟ لأن صلاح الراعي صلاح الرعية. عثمان بن عفان made that statement. إن الله لا يزع بالسلطان ما لا يزع بالقرآن. Sometimes through strength and power and all of that, the affairs of the ummah, because there are a lot of people who needs to fear the authorities in order to shy away from spreading evil in the ummah. That's what Uthman meant. That when the sultan is a good sultan, is a yani the leader is a good leader. What nagging and talking bad about them? I really want them to understand that it's gonna do. Okay, well, just make dua for them that Allah guide them. Udu'u lahu. Listen, if you have a way that you can change him, but hey, you have a plan, it's going to work right away. And there will be no bloodshedding, which is almost impossible. That's why we have texts that say stay away from that. Stay away from that, because in mafsada, the corruptions or the damage, المفاسد, is way higher than the benefit. And look what happened to the Muslim world. I ask Allah to guide our brothers, Ya Rabbal Alameen.